Hi, this is Yosif Xenogiannis and Manos Brilakis from the Minneapolis Heart Institute and the Cardiovascular Innovations Foundation, presenting case 132 for the manual of CTO interventions. This is a case of overcoming proximal cap ambiguity. The patient had ischemic cardiomyopathy, presented with exertional dyspnea and angina. He had ischemia in the anterior and the inferior wall, and on coronary angiography, he was found to have a CTO of the right coronary and the circumflex, and was referred for a canalization of the right coronary artery. A CTA was done before the procedure. There is an occlusion of the proximal right coronary artery. Right at the proximal cap, there is an acute marginal branch. There is also patent LAD with previously placed stents. This is the dual injection. There is ambiguity in the proximal cap due to the takeoff of this large acute marginal branch. The length is approximately 40 millimeters. The distal vessel was filling through septal collaterals. And based on this, the plan was to first try to resolve the proximal cap ambiguity through coregistration and possibly using IVUS into the marginal branch. If that didn't work, then the next approach would be to go retrograde through the septal collaterals, followed by ADR as a third option. Given the patient's low ejection fraction, a right heart catheterization was done before the beginning of the procedure, and because the PA pressure was within normal limits, no hemodynamic support was used. Bilateral femoral access was obtained, EBU for the left and amplatz 1 for the right. And there are several ways to overcome the proximal cap ambiguity. One is to do angiograms on different planes. That did not help in this particular case. The second is to do the CT angiogram, which we had done, and actually use the coregistration, which we'll illustrate in the next slide. The third is to do IVUS, especially if there's a side branch next to the proximal cap, which was the case in our patient with an acute marginal branch. The fourth option is to do a dissection reentry technique proximal to the occlusion and then navigate the occlusion in the submintimal space. And the fifth approach is to go retrograde. In this particular case, we used coregistration with the CT angiogram live, which helped us advance the guidewire slightly. However, there remains still some controversy, and that is why we inserted a workhorse guidewire into the acute marginal branch and then brought an intravascular ultrasound during attempts to advance a guide wire down the right coronary artery. And this is a beautiful illustration of the marginal branch. This is the proximal cap of the vessel. And we can see that the guide wire is actually going within the vessel structure. So this is the vessel, and this is the guide wire we try to advance. So IVUS does confirm that the course of the guide wire is indeed within the true lumen of the vessel. We tried antegrade escalation for some time. However, this did not work, and as a result, we decided to change strategy. We can see the wire made it to the mid-right coronary artery, but then could not go any further. And as a result, septals were used for retrograde crossing. This is a Caravel microcatheter, and various guide wires were used for crossing using the surfing technique. And then eventually, there was successful crossing into the right posterior descending artery, as confirmed by contralateral injection. The other option here is to perform a contrast injection to guide the manipulation of the guide wire, which may be necessary, especially if there is delay in the surfing technique for getting through the lesion. Also, if there are a few collaterals, several collaterals, and one wants to choose the best one, the least tortuous, and the largest in caliber for retrograde crossing. The next step is to cross the chronic total occlusion, and that was challenging. Even though we did have an antegrade guide wire all the way to the mid-right coronary artery and we had retrograde access, we were unable to complete the reverse cart by inflating a balloon over the antegrade guide wire. Solution to this problem include changing the location of the reentry, either more proximal or more distal, and this is called extended reverse cart if the reentry is actually across to the proximal or distal true lumen. The other and the most commonly used one is to use a larger balloon, which can also be measured by intravascular ultrasound for the diameter of the vessel. The other one is to use a guide extension, and finally to change the guide wire, or a combination of all these different approaches. In our case, a 6 French guide liner was inserted to the proximal right coronary artery, and then a pilot 200 guide wire was advanced, and then after inflating the balloon into the proximal right coronary and deflating the balloon and pulling it back into the guide extension, the guide wire eventually popped into the antegrade guide catheter extension. This is the illustration of the so-called draft technique, which stands for deflate, retract, and advanced into the fenestration. This is by Dr. Carlino. And this requires two operators. One of operator is inflating the balloon and then pulling it back, while the second operator is pushing the retrograde guide wire that tracks the course of the deflated antegrade balloon. After crossing, the guide wire was externalized, followed by implantation of 4 drug-eluting stents that provided a nice result with TIMI-3 flow into the right coronary artery. The patient did remain hemodynamically stable throughout the procedure. Several lessons from this case. The first one is the importance of right heart catheterization for determining the need for hemodynamic support. Even though our patient did have a low ejection fraction of 35%, and we ended up going retrograde through the LAD and septal collaterals, given his normal baseline hemodynamics, we did not use support and the patient was fine throughout the procedure. Second, regarding proximal cap ambiguity, both the coregistration of CT angiography as well as use of intravascular ultrasound can clarify the ambiguity. Third lesson is the importance of changing strategy. We tried antegrade but didn't make much progress, and then switching retrograde allowed successful completion of the case. And fourth, there are different methods for troubleshooting reverse cart. The most common one is to use a larger balloon. However, there are other options, such as using a guide extension, as was done in our case, using different retrograde guide wires, and changing the location of the re-entry zone. Thank you.